All right, everybody, it's Wednesday, September 29th, 2010. This is your Daily Dose. I apologize that we haven't been able to be keeping in touch, but it's been hard to access the computer. Plus, to be quite truthful, there's just been a lot going on. For those of you that need to know, we're doing fine. We're A-OK. Right now, we just have a lot of different priorities, and we're just trying to make sure that we address those first and foremost before we, you know, we set up to continue. Now, starting right now, obviously, I'm going to have more steady access to be able to produce videos, so I'll keep putting the videos up. Those will start coming daily again. I also have the ability to respond to emails, so I can still respond to emails. We're doing that nonstop. But as far as speaking about what applies to us and what we're doing and this and what happened here, here's the situation. Right now, we've been raided by federal authorities. I'm going to do everything that I need to do to protect and defend MCCMV and my home from what's happened. Whether or not that applies to other people, I don't know. As far as criminal defense goes, well, we don't know about that yet because we haven't been charged with anything. As far as our civil rights being violated and things of that, well, if you're a licensed patient and we've helped you get your card, or you're living in fear right now because now you're forced to participate in the black market, then you'll be more than welcome to participate in anything that MCCNV does as far as civil rights goes. No problem. In other words, what we're doing has nothing to do with whether, it has to do with our civil rights being violated. And a lot of people don't understand. We haven't been charged with anything criminal. So we can't respond to any allegations of criminal activity because, well, they just took everything, but they haven't really told us what's wrong. But what we can do is fight that what they did on that day was wrong, and we have very good legal precedent to base it on. So that's what we're going to argue about. Now, as far as other patients, right now I have to be honest with you, and I apologize wholeheartedly because for 2 years I thought that what I was doing was right. I thought I was helping the state get money for the budget. I thought I was helping people follow the law. And I continued to help people get their card as often as I possibly could because in the state of Nevada, that activity is legal. Also in the state of Nevada, I had licenses to do these things. So when I helped a patient and then they asked me to make sure that their garden was up to par and I went over and did that and then they did that and ran their garden, to have them raided and to even for a second believe that it could possibly be my fault, it's overwhelming. Because I was just following state law and I actually had licenses from the city and the state to go and do those things. And I actually gave the city 3 months and their city attorneys to look over all of the things that I was doing that were legal, that were, nobody even bothered to ask about them during this investigation in which federal authorities seized my property. It's okay, we're going to fight that. Once again, the Hung Out to Dry campaign, promise. When it's time for you to know about that, you will know, and it will be awesome. That's all I can say. The most important thing that we're working on right now, we're working with our civil rights attorneys, trying to contact any patient that's been affected by these raids or that has been raided and is looking for legal help. Definitely reach out. Let me know. MCCNV, that's what we're here for, people. That's what the charity was designed for, to educate and inform and to provide those type of helps. So if you're a patient that's afraid or you've been violated by the police in some way, email jp@mccnv and see how we might be able to help you. Also, just for the record, our offices are closed. I still will be going down there to move things out and try to salvage what little bit of personal property is left. But as far as actual working out of the office and trying to maintain the lease with the donate, it's not going to happen. Basically, we're going to do all of our work through the Daily Dose. Also, I'm going to be releasing series of DVDs and things of that nature. That way, if you need help, you can still schedule consultations. You'll just have to do it through this website and through the email address. There won't be an actual office to go to. We're still licensed, still all that, still good. Nothing's changed. It's just right now, we're not going to open a location that they're going to use as a piggy bank to just come and take things at their own discretion, with literally no probable cause having to be shown to us. They know that they can do this because they're the big bad government and they've done it in California, they're doing it in Colorado, they've done it other places before. It's their MO, we're used to it. They get away with it because our population hasn't seen it before and isn't familiar with it. But hopefully working with the outlets we're working with, we intend to bring national attention to Las Vegas. And we're gonna do it through the Hung Out the Dry campaign. So make sure you stay tuned for that. As far as what we're doing, the office, once again, you won't find it. But as far as getting help educating and informing Nevada about the medical marijuana program and the way we believe is best to protect yourself now under Nevada law, well, you'll see that development happen through our website and through these videos and through everything that comes out from this moment forward. From day one, we followed the law as best we could, and as soon as we were given evidence to the contrary, for example, give me 1 second. I'm not going to show any names or anything. The second that this happened right here. See those charges? Let me try to get them there. I'm trying to work. See those charges? Charged with 453.337 and 202.360. Now, keep in mind, this was a licensed patient. Give your letter. This was a licensed patient, has his letter from the state, his official notification letter. He also understands his Second Amendment right to protect his family and his home. That's why but you'll see the weapons charge. Because of his medical marijuana, they just thought, oh, well, we'll go ahead and give him a habitual user. As soon as that started happening to a licensed patient that was supposed to be protected under state law, and keep in mind, this is a state of Nevada Clark County warrant, okay? State of Nevada warrant. This isn't federal. As soon as this happened to a licensed patient, all bets were off. I honestly expected this is what would happen to us, a state investigation, but no. Now that they're going after the people that were I was licensed to help in the state of Nevada, that I did help, that I helped in almost every case for absolutely no financial gain whatsoever, and they're going to go and raid these people and uproot their lives as well, well, that's what we do. We adapt, we overcome, and that's what MCCMV is going to do. We adapt, we overcome, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to fight the allegations if they ever make any against us. And we're also going to defend the allegations that have already been levied against this patient. Once again, that charge sheet, just so you see, this says temporary custody record. That means that this person was incarcerated. All right? These bonds, the copies of the bonds, that's the cash that had to come out of his pocket so that he could get out of a jail he shouldn't even have been in. And people wondering, do patients have rights? We're wondering the same thing. But like I said, we're going to defend ourselves. We're going to do what we need to do. The Hung Out to Dry campaign is, when it happens, you'll know it. Those of you that have emailed the Hung Out to Dry at mccmv.com to be on the mailing list, when the time comes, you'll get exactly what you need to get. The press packet, how to help, where to be at, when to be there, and what to bring. So stay tuned for all of that. All right, everybody. This was Wednesday, September 29th, 2010. I know there's so much more to talk about. You have so many more questions, and we'll get to those. We're also going to get on to Ustream as often as we can, because now that we're going to be at home, yeah, you may not be able to get to us at the desk all the time. You'll be able to schedule appointments individually with me. That's the difference. And now, I apologize, but my time is very valuable. So we'll be scheduling individual appointments and working one-on-one with patients. All right? But there'll be more videos to come. I know you have lots of questions. If you do, just email them to us. I'll be more than happy to answer you. But right now, the Hung Out to Dry campaign and raising funds. We have a donor that's matching 9-to-1 on any funds we can raise once we hit $10,000. Our goal right now is to raise $25,000, so that will give us a $250,000 defense to attack what's happening to the patients here in Nevada. So if you can donate, by all means, please email us or give me a call, and we'll be more than happy to take your donation over the phone. We can accept credit cards, and we can also accept cash, and we can arrange to pick that up. This was once again Wednesday, September the 29th, 2010. This is your Daily Dose, and be on the lookout for many more videos coming in the near future.